Welcome to Amaris' Enchanted Garden. I stumbled across this gorgeous venue when I was having lunch with a friend. We walked over across the street and found this beautiful garden that I automatically started imagining everything I could do with this space for my daughter's birthday. So we found it online and it was called Antigua Garden. It was just so gorgeous. Every single part of this courtyard had beautiful spaces that could be really well utilized for the birthday party. It even had this indoor area that was perfect for the dining experience, and then you can walk out to the courtyard. However, it was $800 to reserve this space, and it was just way too much for a child's birthday party. So I started scouting out other gorgeous gardens. I found this location, and it was T. Cook's restaurant at the Royal Palms Resort and Spa in Scottsdale, but once again, too mature for a child's first birthday party. I then found this other restaurant with gorgeous white picket fences that also embodied the Enchanted Garden theme. However, that wasn't going to work out either. Along with other restaurants that I discovered, even this gorgeous one with the tree in the middle and the green couches, which please take note of because we will go back to that because I have so many inspirational images based on that. However, we were very grateful because one of Benny's regulars offered their front yard as a space to hold Amaris' birthday party, and it also had this gorgeous tree right in the middle that would work perfect for the Enchanted Garden theme. Not to mention, this space was also free and it would give me the absolute freedom to create the party as I was envisioning. It would also give more space for children to go run around and play and just really give that friendly, open child's atmosphere and allow the true Enchanted Garden to come to life. One of my first inspirations for this Enchanted Garden theme birthday party was grass furniture. I really loved how this had an Alice in Wonderland type of feel. It made the atmosphere feel so nature-like, but also so magical at the same time. And I feel like if I incorporated this element, it would really take our guests to another place and make them feel like they're really stepping into this enchanted world. I went onto sites like Facebook Marketplace and OfferUp and realized that I could type in free furniture and free furniture would actually pop up, just like this couch right here. I thought this was perfect if I bought turf and I could glue it on and turn it into this. Because the couch was such a clean structure, it would be easy to recreate this look. However, when I was searching other inspirational images, I also found this grass couch that really stood out to me because of the elegant curvature in the arms of the couch. So I then looked at other options such as this imprinted leaf-like pattern on couches that would bring that grass furniture look to life without actually having to purchase turf that can be really expensive. This particular couch was only $30 and it came with this ottoman that had the matching print. There was also so many other couches that had this like leaf grass pattern to it. This one right here was very elegant with the floral pillows that really inspired me later on, as well as looking up floral couches. This one in particular had the couch, the love seat, as well as the wing back chair and ottoman, which was really cool. I also really looked into love seats that had that royal element, as well as wood couches that I could use the turf to only put on the seating area instead of the whole couch, and that could possibly save me a lot of money. So that was my inspiration behind all of the couch furniture I could turn into grass furniture. Enchanted Garden furniture led me to the inspirational images of Enchanted Garden dining. I love this image because it really embraces nature once again taking over your you know, typical household furniture and turning it into something very beautiful and ethereal. I really also love the idea of taking tree stumps and turning them into chairs for the dining table. So I looked up on OfferUp and Marketplace again to see if there was free stumps available, and there is. So if you're interested in that, just go ahead and type that in and they might be close to you. There's also this option on Amazon, which I found was super funny. This is actually a kid's kind of plush, almost pillow-like stump. So that was a great idea, but I think it was a little bit expensive for the quality, and this wouldn't really seat adults that well. I also started looking into this recently popular kind of boho theme with these really ornate centerpieces that I find super beautiful, but I really wanted to stick more to the woodland theme. That brought me to then start looking up these picnic style benches that kind of would work as a good middle ground. But then I started to discover these really beautiful, kind of vintage looking dining sets that I feel like really embraced that kind of tea party, again, Alice in Wonderland, Mad Hatter style that I just love. And this is also a great DIY to just fully sand, paint white, or detail the chairs as you would like to. So that kind of got me really excited looking at all of these different dining options. I also really liked this kind of stone-like dining table that had these really beautiful details on it, on the legs. And I'm really into, you know, curvature, kind of French, Italian styled furniture, and this was awesome. There was also other pieces that kind of embodied more of the bark and wood side of the Enchanted Forest, and these tables would work perfectly for that, looking kind of like tree stumps, and I could also again take that turf and use it as the padding for the chairs. So that's where all of that inspiration came from. I also looked at garden chairs, which I started to fall in love with. I really love this woven pattern with the rose and leaf detailing at the top of the chair. However, this was kind of expensive to purchase, so I started looking at other white plastic chairs, such as these, that have a really beautiful pattern on them as well. And they are actually available at a couple online local sites, such as this one right here. However, this particular vendor required a $200 deposit, so I decided to go with another chair vendor and just get the plain white chairs that worked perfectly for the party. But I was able to find some other beautiful chair options that I incorporated into the party as well. I found these white plastic chairs on OfferUp for free that I actually went to go pick up to add to the lawn lounge area that worked perfectly. I just threw some garden pillows on top and it really added to the scenery. For the lounge area, I also wanted to find some modern chairs or vintage romantic looking chairs. Or also these beautiful Victorian chairs that I was absolutely obsessed with, and they were green, so I could easily do a DIY project on them, such as this, and add the turf or the moss to really enhance the beauty of the chair. I also found some more free options that were absolutely incredible just waiting on the side of the curb, such as these two matching chairs with the matching side table. And can you believe these were free? These French, beautiful, stunning chairs. Like, I am obsessed. So, my obsession with looking up free chairs continued, and I actually found these online the day before Amaris's birthday, and I had to pick them up because they were exactly what I was looking for. The structure of this was absolutely perfect, and the fact that it was already a DIY chair was also perfect because then I could just really do whatever I wanted to it. And it was okay. So, this is my Enchanted Chair DIY project.
into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation.
Besides an enchanted chair, it was really important for me to find an enchanted bench. I wanted this bench for Amaris's birthday party as a prop for little kids to go on there and take a photo and really feel like they're in an enchanted garden. So my search began with this gorgeous little cute bench. However, I realized this was literally like an inch big from Michael's. So the hardest part about this was finding a life-size bench, but child size. So I started looking at kind of like this log-inspired bench look, and then it turned more into just any unique wood bench that was an interesting shape or had interesting detailing on it that really stood out to me. I really like this one, for example, with the floral pattern at the top, or the white picket fence look, and this one right here to match the all white garden inspired look that I saw on the chairs that I showed you previously, right here with the rose detailing on it. I also just love that Victorian feel, so it's really getting hard to decide. This Greek one, for example, is beautiful, and even just the stone one with the lions on it, since my daughter's a Leo. But this one I absolutely loved, with the princess style pillars going all the way to the top. I actually fell in love with that one, but I didn't hear a response back from the person selling it. So I actually went with this bench because it was only $10. It was a fixer upper and it still had that princess enchanted quality. So I was excited to do a DIY on this. However, Benny actually ended up taking over and did a great job. So here is a look at that. Dessert Inspo was so fun to search for. I absolutely loved this gorgeous cake with the grass, moss, and floral details. It definitely was a huge inspiration for all the desserts I was looking forward to have. I also really loved these two options right here. They definitely have a snow white quality to them, just entering into the enchanted forest. And these cupcakes right here were absolutely gorgeous. The flower detail with the little patches of grass, and it was just, I love them so much, but they were so expensive and I looked up how to make them and it was a little difficult, so maybe next year. However, the lady that so generously let us use her home for Amaris's birthday party also had made this caterpillar cake and other cupcakes that she showed me pictures of in case I wanted it for her birthday party, and of course I said yes. And I thought they would be great for her theme. I also found these fairy cupcake toppers that were so cute and I had to get from Amazon. I also found these tree stump wrappers that also went with the theme, as well as the white picket fence that I was talking about earlier that I thought would be super cute. Okay, here is a list of random things I found that I think I needed for this party. So we're gonna start with arches. I think arches are so beautiful, typically seen at weddings, but I really wanted an archway or an entryway into the party that made you feel like you're walking into the enchanted garden. So I found this gorgeous archway. However, it was a little bit too expensive. So luckily on Facebook Marketplace, I found two archways for $15. for both of them. So that was great. Then I was thinking, oh, maybe I could add some white picket fence like around it, but that was just me being a little too extra, so I didn't go that far. And next I started seeing all of these really cute playhouses. So I just started my search on that, and there is a lot of playhouses out there for good prices. However, again, I was being a little too extra, but I do really want to make this a DIY project for my daughter one day, most likely when we have a house and a backyard, so I could have this out there for her and she'll have a beautiful place to play. Moving on, I saw a lot of dessert carts that I thought were so cute. There was a ton of white ones that were for rent, but I found this one that could have easily turned into a DIY project as well. So that's just maybe something for the next party. Then I found these floral pillows online inspired by the couch picture I showed you at the beginning of the video. I found this drop dead gorgeous pillow on Amazon that is a 3D flower made of tulle, and I just think it is so gorgeous. I love it so much. I'm definitely gonna buy this later to put in her crib. But the one I ended up getting was a set of four with different flowers on each pillow that I ended up using on the couch and the white rocking chairs I showed earlier. These are really fun with that log inspiration and just kind of stump inspo. I found this log pillow and a little stump chair pad, which I thought was so cute, as well as these name tags for the dining area that I also didn't end up getting just because I wanted people to have the freedom to sit wherever they wanted, but this would be great for like a wedding or more of a formal party. What is an enchanted garden without plants? I really got inspired by these topiary trees, I believe is how they're pronounced. They're so regal yet so whimsical and just are so beautiful. I also found this version of them, which is a little bit rounder of a bush and has flower inserts, which I absolutely love. I also really like the ones that come with the more antique looking pots, and this berry one was really unique. It gave me a very Grecian, statuesque, Romeo and Juliet, I don't know, just romantic eating berries vibe, and I loved that. I also was looking at more kind of like abandoned forest trees as well. I love just like seeing the bark and the leafless branches. I was also thinking that matching fake tree planters such as these would be so perfect just as they are, or even to do a DIY project on them by spray painting them really fun colors, or even adding some floral arrangement around it as well. Also, fake vines such as these on Amazon are really great to have along with other garland. I used some of the garlands I already had from my baby shower last year to wrap around the arches and just really incorporate florals in any part of the party I could. Thank you for watching all of my enchanted party inspiration decorations thus far. Now I'm going to show you what I actually ended up purchasing. So one of my favorite and honestly best purchases was this photo wall. It was such an amazing quality. It was actually made out of wood, the white picket fencing, and it had the grass squares perfectly inserted. It is an 8x8 wall, so it's really, really big, perfect for taking photos. The dimensions are awesome, and you can also attach flowers as you please. Or I was also thinking about purchasing the gold custom lettering such as this one right here. However, it was not going to come in on time, so I had the idea of getting these insert roses, which were perfect because with the stems I could just put it into the little grass patches on the photo wall and create Amaris's name. So that's what I ended up doing. I also got this 3D leaf string that I was able to tie to
some of the decorations, such as this centerpiece that I used for my baby shower last year. I took off the original diamonds and I put in the little leaf strings to make it look a little bit more nature-like instead of glam. And as I mentioned before, I ended up getting these pillows as well as the green couch for $30 that came with the ottoman. I got these white rocking chairs for free. I got these DIY chairs that I showed you guys that I turned into grass chairs also for free. And I got this bench for $10 that I also did a DIY on earlier in the video that I showed, and I got these amazing French chairs for free. There was a total of four of them, and I used them for the round table. For the round table, I bought this round table floral cloth that was absolutely beautiful and perfect, and it matched these rectangular tablecloths, both on Amazon. Also on Amazon, I got these cupcake holders as well as the bark inspired cupcake wrappers I showed, the fairy cupcake toppers, and one of my other favorites was this plate set. It was so amazing. It came with a total of 50 plates and they were just this gorgeous white with gold trimming. It was so royal looking, and the best part about it is it came with cups, knives, spoons, forks, dessert plates, and main course plates, as well as napkins. So it was definitely an amazing set, and it is reusable, so that's amazing. I also got these grass table runners. I actually bought three of them, and for one of them I used on the DIY chairs. The other two I used as table runners for the two main tables. I also bought Amaris these little floral clips that you'll see in the following birthday video, are all kind of layered on the side of her head into a bigger just floral headpiece that turned out really cool. I got the two metal arches for $15, such a great deal. I also got these floral garland on Amazon, as well as the vines, and there was a lot more things that I was able to reuse for my baby shower, as well as just things I had around the house that made for great decorations as well. I actually took a screenshot of this dress a year ago, right after I had my daughter, for a potential mother and daughter photo shoot. However, I ended up saving it until her birthday. And I also found this other beautiful picture of a very similar dress. But I loved these sleeves, how they were sheer but still had the 3D flowers. This was also a great option with just the florals as the strap. So the first thing I did was try to scout down this fabric. I found it on Amazon, but there's also options on Etsy that could be cheaper. But the one on Amazon came the soonest, so I went with that one. I called up Herschel, asked him if he could make these dresses for me within a very short amount of time. He got my measurements, he got my daughter's measurements, and he made the pattern. We got fitted, and boom, the dress was made. Amaris was so cute when she was trying it on. She felt like a true princess with her arms out, just floating, truly embracing the moment, and I'm so happy with how these turned out.
Thank you. it's cold outside, I've got the month of May. I guess you've said, what can make me feel this way? My girl,
my girl,
my girl,
talking about my girl. I've got so much honey, the bees envy me. I've got a sweeter song than the birds in the trees. Well, I guess you say, what can make me feel this way? My girl,
my girl,
my girl,
talking about my girl.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed all of my inspiration behind this birthday party, and please make sure to subscribe, like, and ring the notification bell to watch more of my videos. See you guys next time. Bye!